Hello and welcome to The Wave of Things. My name is André Savitier. In the past, I covered sometimes games, namely adventure games, but only a little bit. And as I'm very much interested in this kind of games, I invited for today's talk someone who has some expertise in this field. Welcome, Marion, also known as, maybe I pronounce it wrong, Shaila.
Shaila, yes, that's my nickname as a game creator.
I found you because I played some of your games and I liked them very much. I saw that you already made quite some games, but I think before we go into the games more, maybe you could introduce yourself a little bit.
I'm French and I'm a comic book drawer. I draw comic books for a living since 20 years about, and I play video games as a hobby since I'm a child. I love video games. I want to tell stories other ways than just than by drawing and comic books, and then I like creating my own video games to tell stories with other media.
Good. What kind of comic books are you drawing?
My most popular comic book is called The Dungeon of Nahelbeck. It is written by John Lang, also known as Pen of Chaos. He's a famous writer on internet, and he wrote this saga. It's an audio saga that can be downloaded on internet, and I really loved it. It's about a company who explores a dungeon exactly like they are in a role-playing game, and they talk about the experience, gaining levels, and that's very, very funny. It's a fantasy, humoristic story, and I really, really enjoyed it. So I asked John if I could adapt his story in comic book. I already had a publisher who were interested, and that's how we made this comic book together.
How many of those comic books did you already publish?
Yes, there are 24 until now, since 15 years.
Wow.
And more to come.
I don't know a lot about, I know some graphic novels, I used to read some of them, but I wanted to ask you, who are your influences in this sphere?
I read mostly French comic books and graphic novels, like Spirou, Tintin, Tintin, Asterix, all those classical. And later, when I grew up, I was very interested in fantasy, mostly through movies like Dark Crystal, and I read Lord of the Rings, and so I was looking for comic books, fantasy books, and I read La Quête de l'Oiseau du Temps, Time Bird Quest by Loisel, that I really enjoyed it. And that was one of my influences, and also The Smurfs by Peyo. Yeah. But today my most influence are mostly movies and TV shows.
Are you a nerd?
Oh yes, definitely a nerd, yes. Yes, I always enjoy the fantasy and sci-fi world more than the real world.
For today, I'm wearing my only game shirt. Do you know this symbol?
I know I saw it, but I can't remember the game.
It's also from an adventure game that actually combines both your liking sci-fi and fantasy. It's from Dreamfall, The Longest Journey.
Yes, I heard about it, but I didn't play it.
You make your own adventure games?
And
I would
yes.
be interested how you came to this idea to make adventure games yourself.
I always enjoyed games in general since I'm a child, and I discovered adventure games, especially adventure games, when my family got an Atari, a PC, Atari ST. And my father once offered me a game for my birthday, and it was Zack McCracken and the Alien Mindbender. And I really, really fell in love with that game. And I played it a lot. I really, really enjoyed the liberty we have in that kind of game. We can go anywhere, try everything. And that's really what I like, explore and try. And so I wanted to discover other games like that. And then I discovered Monkey Island, Maniac Mansion, and Sierra Games, and Future Wars. All the type of games, and that was my favorite at that time. I love many type of games, but especially adventure games. Yes. The last I played was I can't remember the name. It's about two agents who were investigating in a strange town, and it was very old school. It looks like a lot like Maniac Mansion.
It was Thimbleweed Park, huh?
Yes, that's it, Thimbleweed Park, yes.
I wanted to ask you also about the themes of many of your games you made. Also, things that interest me. For example, you had one about pirates.
Yes.
Monkey Island, I think we all love pirates.
Yes. Well, in fact, before I made the Dungeon of Nalbeck, my comic books, I wrote and drawn a comic book myself with the same publisher, and it's about a pirate girl who is called Doane McFarlane. And in five books, I told a story.
Another one I played, this was very good, it was the Sherlock Holmes game.
Yeah, Sherlock Holmes, yes.
It's about the new Sherlock Holmes by Stephen Moffat. No?
Yes, the Moffat Sherlock. TV show. Yes.
Yeah, it was a very nice game. And now a new one you made about vampires. I thought I should interview you. Because, of course, most music I'm talking about is somehow connected to vampires and the darkness.
Yes, that's a word I love a lot too. I didn't have many games with vampires. I made the last one, The Mortifer. But yes, for the moment, I had to delete it because I use assets from the game The Sims, and Electronic Arts was not very happy about it. So I had to send them an email to ask for permission to use, and I am waiting for their answer before I put it online again.
Now, this is actually a huge problem with indie game makers, no?
There were yes.
A lot of games connected with Indiana Jones, for example, fan games.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And they had to stop or to take it down or change the story.
Yes, I heard about it. That's a bit sad, I think. But I understand as you make a fan game or you use the existing universe, that's a risk, I think.
It's a pity because exactly the nerd culture also lives from, let's say, from adding to those universes, no?
Yes.
For example, the Star Wars, Star Trek, Lord of the Rings. Yes, people yes. make their own stories in those universes.
Yes, I really love that. I love when people own those universes to make their own stories and their own feelings, their own characters. In the universe they love, as I do myself.
I don't understand why those companies are then so against it, because basically it's a free commercial for their product.
Yes. I suppose it depends on the companies. It's people behind that decide, and you can't really know what will happen if we do that.
Are you in also into some kind of music culture?
I listen mostly at soundtracks, movie soundtracks, video game soundtracks, but I'm not really into pop music. I like some singers, but not many. Some folk groups, but I mostly listen to some tracks.
Marion, thank you very much for this talk. I wish you good luck for all your graphical work. It means computer games and their graphic novels.
I hope to. I will go on, and I hope to make other comic books and other games to show you and everyone who are looking at us. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Marion. Bye bye.
Bye.